Gentlemen, honestly, we do love you, but when it comes to impressing us, sometimes you go a little bit too far. We can see when you are trying too hard to gain our attention. Sometimes when you are doing this, you actually end up making more mistakes than you thought you actually would. And I am here to stop you from making those exact mistakes. In today's video, we are going to talk about some of the dumbest mistakes that guys make when they are trying their hardest to impress a lady. My name is Anna, and keep watching to find out a little bit more. The first thing to address is you sometimes are a little bit too sexual. When you first meet a lady or you are going out on that very first date, it's so important to not be too sexual. Because if you come on too strong and all you want to really do is sleep with her, she's gonna find you very creepy. And yes, not gonna end very well, is it? If you show your sexual intentions too early on, it's gonna put the lady off and she might end up rejecting you. And on the flip side, not being sexual at all. If you are dating and have been for a while, it's important that you drop some sexual hints throughout the whole flirting stage. This is to avoid being friend-zoned by the lady, of course. Because if she thinks that you are not interested in her in a sexual way, she's going to find someone else who totally is. So make sure you don't actually shut off this area of the romance. And if you are trying to impress a lady, be a little bit sexual, but wait a couple of dates in. You can still be flirty because that's suggestive, but don't do anything too romantically sinister until later on. Don't act too cool. Too cool for school, this is not something that we want at all. We do like it when you are naturally cool and a little bit mysterious, just not like you are too cool to be on the date with a lady, if that makes sense. Do not ever try to be someone you are not, and do not exaggerate your coolness. It's very creepy. This one makes me laugh. Pretending to share her hobbies. There is nothing worse than when a guy pretends to share his hobbies. It's amazing when you actually do share the same hobbies as a lady because it's a great foundation to build a solid relationship on. But it's not great though, however, to say that you have the same interest as her. We know that you are doing this to lie to come across as a better catch, and it's going to be very awkward a few weeks later when she, I don't know, takes you horseback riding and you have no idea what to do and you fall off. She will realize that you've lied to her and played along, and guys, just don't ever do this to a lady. It's not good. Texting her too much. No one likes being bombarded with text 24/7. It's cute at the beginning for the guy to message the girl first, and she will most definitely have those little butterflies in her stomach. And if you are messaging her all of the time though, asking what she's getting up to, she's gonna get bored of it very quickly. This is never going to impress her, so reel it back just a little. And if I didn't need to confuse you anymore, texting too little is also not a good thing, because on the opposite side of the spectrum, if you come across that you're not interested in her, well, she's not going to want to spend time with you. So if it takes you too long to message her back, she's just gonna think, you know what, I'm gonna pull away and find someone else. You need to text her just the right amount, so answer her messages, but don't leave it until the next day, do it on the same day. Flashing the cash. Ladies love it when a guy pays for dinner, and they also like it if a guy has money, but what we don't like is a man who shows off the money that he has. I mean, on the flip side, imagine it was you. You want to date a lady that is financially stable because you don't want to be providing for her, and that's how we feel. We don't want to mother a guy. We like it when a guy has money, but we don't care how much you actually have. Obviously, I'm talking about the high value ladies here. If you start talking about all the expensive cars you have or all the money that you have in a bank, well, it's not going to attract us. The point is, guys, ladies really, really don't like it. They would rather you just say nothing and just pay for the meal. It's as easy as that. Spoiling her from the get-go. It's super nice if you pay for dinner, and then spoiling her with gifts is also nice, especially on the first date. But if you keep doing it, it's gonna get a little bit cringy. Don't get me wrong, if you have some flowers from time to time, this is cute and we love it. And jewelry is actually a really nice thing as well, but please don't think that you have to buy a lady's attention. If you do, you're basically aiming for the wrong type of lady, the low value ones. If she is a very high value lady, you don't need to give her gifts to get her attention. Talking about your education. talking about the school you went to, the college or the university, it's, yeah, I guess, impressive. But talking about how smart you are is not so impressive. Let the lady approach this subject, especially if you went to a private school. Otherwise, it can come across a little bit over the top. If she asks about your education, tell her about it, but please don't show off. The first kiss is such a magical moment, and a lady will dream about the first kiss for so long before it happens. So when it finally does happen, make sure it is magical. Don't ram your tongue down her throat or just going too hard. Make it romantic, gentle, and lovely. That's going to really, really impress her. Using big words to sound smart. This does not impress ladies. There is nothing more downgrading than a man who uses words that he just cannot understand. It's obvious you are doing this to sound smart, not because you actually use those words in everyday sentences. It isn't sexy. Just stick to your normal vocabulary and I promise you, she's gonna love you. Making the first date too extravagant. Putting some effort into a date is lovely, and I've said this in past videos, that a unique date is just amazing and special to a lady. Just don't make it too over the top. For example, taking her to a black tie event would be, wow, a little bit too far. She will be thinking, what will our other dates be like? Is this the peak? Does it get like more extreme? Like, am I prepared for this? She might also think you're trying too hard. So keep the first date simple and unique, because that's the winning formula, gentlemen. Meet the friends and family. If you are in a relationship, this is, well, it's nice and it's very, very important, providing the friendship and the family is very healthy. If it's the first date, it would be strange and off-putting to ask the lady to meet your family. It would also be strange for you to say, I can't wait to meet your family on the first date. If it all goes well, these things are going to naturally happen next. You just have to wait for it to happen. Don't rush. Giving too many compliments. Giving a lady compliments is important when it comes to dating. Because if you over-compliment her though, it comes across as very, very desperate. Giving her a few well-thought-out genuine compliments is lovely. Complimenting her every 5 seconds is not. Think of a couple of genuine compliments and say them to her, and this will go a lot further. Acting needy. If you start acting too needy early on, your crush is simply going to leave you. They will not want to be in a relationship with someone who is going to be very, very needy. This includes always having to ask to see them, wanting to know what they are up to throughout the day. You are better off just giving your crush that natural space, specifically at the beginning. The more they miss you, the better, and the higher chances you will have at an actual secure long-term relationship. Not having clear set intentions. If you act like you don't want to be on the date or date that lady, she's going to be very confused and she won't actually understand why you are even there. You might be protecting yourself by trying to not act too interested, but this is going to be very counterproductive. To her, it will look like you don't want to be there, and so after the date, she won't bother contacting you again. Instead, tell her that you are so excited to be on this date with her. And this goes without saying, if you are just wanting a one-night stand, make this clear as well, gents. She will probably be keen for a one-night stand as well, who knows? But if you play it out on a date, when in fact all you wanted to do was to sleep with her as a one-time thing, it's gonna hurt her. So just be honest from the get-go and set those clear intentions. So gentlemen, I hope you have learned something today. Try your hardest to avoid these mistakes and everything is gonna work out a-okay. See you in the next video. If you think I missed something from today's video, let me know down in the comments. Give me a huge thumbs up and consider subscribing to make my day. But if you want to get your name rolling up next to my face, like these amazing people's names here, then all you have to do is click the link in the description bar below to find out a little bit more. Have an amazing day. See you soon.